This week, the Department of Corrections and the Judiciary Committee came before Appropriations. My question's geared toward the youth and making sure that families stay together when a member is in prison.
My concern is about the elimination of MDJ offices. I love that you're streamlining. I love that you're saving money. But my concern is that that these offices are a gateway to the criminal system, and I would like the judges to make fair and thoughtful decisions, especially with our youth, instead of being bombarded with too many cases, getting them through as quickly as possible just to check them off the list. What are some of the feedback that you've heard, good or bad, in regards to elimination? And then moving forward, what is the process? How do you decide which one to eliminate versus which one to keep? I had a constituent come to me, a male, who said that after opening up to me, he said that his son was born when he went to prison. And after he left prison, after 17 years, his son went into prison. So they totally passed each other. And I think family members of incarcerated people pay a high price for their family members' mistake. What are you doing to help reunite family members? I think at Muncie you have some kind of programming where you have family members talking to each other throughout their sentence. Deputy Secretary Smeal, thank you so much for inviting me to Muncie. It changed my whole perspective on inmates. I thought they're hard, scary criminals, and they're just regular people like me. A lot of them sexual assault victims, addictions, just really sad people who made a mistake in life. And it's humanize the inmates, and that if we humanize them and have more compassion, give them the supports, they'll do better. We'll save money. Hopefully we don't need a prison population, you know, a big one, and I think it's good for all of us.
During the last and final week, I'll be focusing on the Department of Education and the Office of the Budget. We'll have a lot more questions to make sure that this budget works for my constituents of the 103rd District.